بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه والاه. The naming of the Quranic chapters. سورة الإسراء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named سورة الإسراء for the obvious reason related to the first verse, which is سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا. Glory be to the one who has taken his slave, meaning here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from Masjid al-Haram to Al-Masjid al-Aqsa. So Isra is a night journey. The word Isra actually comes from the meaning of night journey, to walk or to move during the night. And so Al-Isra is the part of the night journey which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transferred the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Al-Qudus, from Al-Masjid al-Haram to Al-Masjid al-Aqsa, to show him of the signs that he has prepared for him. And because of this verse at the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has named this surah, Surah al-Isra. It's almost like a transportation. It's a movement. It's going from one place to another to see the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you read Surah Al-Isra, you also feel, you will see that there are verses which are about transporting and transforming you as an individual in many ways. We have verses in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about his signs. We have verses where he talks about some of the akhlaq and the adab that a person should do. You know, there's a whole list of things, starting with the worshipping of Allah and being good to parents, and then going through being righteous to others and so on. So the whole chapter of Isra is linked to that dimension. But it also has another dimension. This is the other name of Alhamdulillah. And the other name of Surah Al-Isra, which is Surah Bani Israel. So it's also known as the chapter of the children of Israel. And again, the reasoning for that is because it also mentions at the beginning of the Surah Bani Israel, and it also talks about the end, it mentions them as well, and the case between Fir'aun and Musa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a very special mention here, and this is part of the prophecy of the Quran. And it says that when the second promise comes, and he was talking to Bani Israel, when the second promise comes, we will bring you from throughout the world, we will gather you from throughout the world. And subhanallah, today this prophecy has happened with the formation of the state of Israel, and that the children of Israel, the Jews, have come. I mean, they're not all of them, but many of them have come and settled in Israel. And it's a prophecy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions specifically in this chapter, the children of Israel. Also, another surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we're going to mention is Surah Al-Anbiya. Surah Al-Anbiya is a chapter which is named the prophets, and again, it's a very, very straightforward reason for mentioning that, because half of the surah talks about stories of the prophets. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes through the mention of many of the prophets, and he mentions them in brief, pointing and directing us to some of the important aspects related to these prophets. What's interesting, though, as well, that in this surah, which is named prophets, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions Maryam alayhi salam. And from this perspective, some of the ulama have derived that Maryam is also a prophet, which is there is quite a difference between the ulama about this, but that is one of the reasons behind that. Surah Al-Hajj is also named Surah Al-Hajj because in Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the essence of Hajj, how it started with Ibrahim alayhi salam and some of the ahkam and some of the rules of Hajj. It's not the only surah that talks about Hajj, because Surah Al-Baqarah also mentioned Hajj, but here there is that direction within Surah Al-Hajj to be understood about certain aspects in terms of the sha'air, the rituals related to Hajj. But Hajj also has a bigger picture, because Hajj is about intention, it's about purpose. And this surah also sets the purpose for the believer, and understanding their mission, understanding their role in life, and also understanding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the functions of a person. And very nicely towards the end of Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that this practice, this deen of yours is based on the deen of Ibrahim, the millah of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And it's because of Ibrahim that you are named Muslimin. Although the verse has two meanings. One is that maybe it's Allah who named you the Muslimin, or the other meaning is that Ibrahim is the one who named you Muslimin, because Ibrahim alayhi salam, he submitted to Allah. He did the aslama, Islam. So from there becomes the name Muslim. Or it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named you the Muslimin because he chose for you this deen, وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. And that's part of the naming of the Hajj as well, because the Hajj also is a journey with that submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this very short lesson, we spoke about Surah Al-Isra and the Surah Al-Anbiya and Surah Al-Hajj. Inshallah, we'll end there.